I'm Andy Weinberg with Miller Electric. I handle the motorsports marketing for Miller, and we get a lot of questions for TIG welding, precisely aluminum. Even from beginners to experienced welders who do a lot of welding with steel, a lot of people have some problems working with aluminum. So we're going to cover some of the issues with working with aluminum today. So we're going to start with the basics. I'm going to show you my four-step top secret method on welding aluminum that we tell everybody. So let's get started with that, and hopefully we can learn something. For this segment, we're going to be using the diversion. It's a fairly basic beginner type machine. Very easy to work with. When we start with aluminum, a lot of people try to go too far too fast. We like to slow people down a little bit. Our first method on working with aluminum is we don't even try and stalk an arc. We want to get positioning of the torch, hand control, the motion. We want to work on that first before we even get to striking an arc and making all kinds of scrap. In this configuration, whether you're left-handed or right-handed, try to get comfortable first. Hold the torch, bracing it with the base of your hand, and we're going to try and keep this in a steady, forward-moving position with a slight angle of the torch. We're also trying to keep a fairly close distance from the tungsten to the workpiece. If you get too high, the arc spreads out too wide, ends up really overheating the piece, and you lose your puddle control. Working with aluminum is all about puddle control. It's a lot harder than steel. Steel is fairly easy. The puddle is a lot more forgiving. It's not as finicky. The aluminum, being a much higher heat sink, it wants to suck the heat away from your weld area. So therefore, you really need to watch the puddle when working with aluminum.